So between mummies and the Magna Carta, we have the space cookie.
Space food is a really important part of an astronaut's life in space. And over the years, packaging has changed dramatically, and what we can eat in space looks almost completely different from what it did during the days that astronauts landed on the moon. We put things like the ISS cookie on display to show people the progression of how we've moved from the early days of space food to today, and really show you the capability change in preparing food and having food available for astronauts.
When the cookie arrived, it was frozen and it came in its container. And what we needed to do was figure out how to preserve it just as it is, just as you see on display. So our first job in figuring out how to preserve a cookie that was baked in space was to replicate the process of how it was made. So we followed the recipe that Hilton used to bake a cookie, and then we froze them for 6 months to replicate the experience that our first cookie baked in space had. So once it was frozen, we took it out of the freezer and went through a process of figuring out how we can desiccate it carefully and slowly so that we don't have any moisture inside of the package while it's on display. In this particular instance, we really want to minimize any potential moisture because that will contribute to biological growth.
In order to do that, we designed and had a specialized case that you see it on display in, manufactured, that we could actually draw a vacuum and draw all of the air out from the cookie inside and its specialized pouch, and then introduce nitrogen, pure nitrogen, back into that environment, keep it in an enclosed container, and then be able to put that on display.
Two things that we've included in this display that nobody will see is a small indicator that will tell us when oxygen is present inside of it. This is indicated by a color change. And this is a small dot that you can see if you get very low. If you're at about 3 feet from the ground and you look up, you can see it.
One of the things we included in order to simplify the display of the cookie is a small capsule of a desiccant known as a microsieve. A material similar to what you might find in a pair of new shoes in the box, the little pouches to have moisture removed from its environment.
It took us about 8 months from the time we acquired the cookie. We did our documentation of what the cookie looks like when it first arrives, and really taking the time to diagnose what the attendant problems are with this particular cookie and how we're going to keep it on display and make sure that it doesn't change over time. So the first thing we had to learn was what's been done previously. So we looked for parallels within the conservation community and found that while there's not a whole lot that's published about food in particular, there are things that have similar properties where moisture is either a problem or moisture is not a problem, and or it's a problem in a different way. I'm thinking about mummies, for example. You don't want to have any moisture added to something that's been extremely desiccated over time. And other important documents that are on parchment, we have the Magna Carta that's on display in a very similar kind of condition where you really don't want any moisture and it has to stay even over time. I mean, one of the interesting things about working at the Air and Space Museum is that we have all these one-of-a-kind materials and we can't necessarily find examples to follow. So we have to use our science background to understand what is the essence of the problem here and who has done something similar that we can borrow from and adapt. Come and see our space cookie on display at the Udvar-Hazy Center in the Human Space Flight exhibit case.
Let us know what your favorite part of this video was in the comment section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. Also, you can follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and be sure to subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.